Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we know that the A to C is 4 centimeters. So let me just put that down right here for you. So it's 4 centimeters from here to here, okay? And B to D is from here to here. It's 15 centimeters in total. But instead of me doing the 15, I'm going to divide into 2 first, okay? Because, so 15 divided by 2, we got 7.5. But because it's a bisector, so these two sides right here, the two segments here and here, they're both equal. So the total is 15. If you divide by 2, you get 7.5 from here and a 7.5 here as well. Okay? So far, so good? So take a look. They're looking for the diameter of the circle, but we can actually draw our own radius. See, from here to here, A to B, the reason I would actually draw a line right here is because I want to form a right triangle. Okay? So there's a right triangle right here. I know this side's a 4, this is my right 90 degrees, and I know this side's a 7.5. This is actually known as your C, which is the radius or the hypotenuse, the C of the hypotenuse, right? So why are we looking for this? Because this is your radius, okay? So why are we looking for the radius? Well, if you can figure out your radius times by 2, what do you get? Diameter, right? So that's why we need to find the radius first. So to find the C, remember, you have the Pythagoras theorem. So we got 4 squared plus 7.5 squared, and just find the C. All you have to do is square root the whole thing once you figure this out. So grab your calculator, go 4 squared plus 7.5 squared, and don't forget to square root the whole thing. I have 8.5. Now remember, this is your radius, okay? So the radius is 8.5. Now what about diameter? Well, why don't we just times by 2? So the diameter for this question is just 8.5 times by 2. The answer turns out to be just 17 centimeters. And that is the answer for this question. Thanks for watching.